Bye-bye. I am tired of this life. I'm going back. I don't know her number. I know her number before.
No, sir.
I don't know her number. I said, I now repeat. I said, you will never ever go back to anywhere. Go back to where you come from. Now, and give me your number. Now she now gave me her number. 080 GCC. Then I just type. Then I send it. I dial the number. I call the number. Say, who is this? Where are you? I come now. The same date that she told me. They said, that is the date you're going to die, whether you like it or not. She was surprised. She said, how you take no? I won't go through this. I said, you want to go to abortion now? Your spirit cried unto me just now. Come to church, Christ, Messiah. Now. When she came, who? Now you? Apple. Praise the Lord.
Louange à l'éternel.
Look at it now. Oyibo. Oyibo, you can see the baby now. See the baby. Oyibo, you won't kill this baby before. This is the handwork of God's apple.
Apple.
Wow, that was wonderful. Apple babies are untouchable, you know.
Yes.
You cannot touch them. You cannot destroy these Apple babies. Wow.
You know, listening to this testimony shows that God is really awesome, because she was thinking she doesn't need a baby yet. Well, you see that fine baby boy.
She wanted to pull it out.
I discovered something about Apple babies. Okay. You can't bring them down when they are not ready to come back. She was going for abortion. And
it was kind of surprising how the men of God located.
Because she said,
God has started something now. God has started something, so he's not going to let the thing cut off halfway.
Mm. Mm. Yes.
So the cost of that thing is definitely going to manifest.
And how God monitored the children to make sure
Let's see how it is, because that night she said the night she wanted to go, she was planning to go for the abortion the next day. God just revealed it to his servant prophet Jeremiah, a phone number, as she said.
Yes. He called her,
and she was like, this is the first time, I'm not going to, it's just a first that is trying to claim prophet Jeremiah Motufui. She didn't believe when the man of God told her what she was about to do. That to say, God knows what you're about
and
to do.
And definitely she has not told anyone. So yes. it was like amazing.
It's God who created you. Mm-hmm. So definitely knows you yesterday.
Today.
And tomorrow.
And he knew, you know, what convinced her was the prophecy part of it. When man of God called her, she doubted it. But when he started telling her what she was thinking in her heart, it started making
which
sense.
Which she has not told anyone.
This must be God that must be revealing.
You know, if you want to analyze the miracles that took place with just that apple prayer, is she got her healing.
Yeah.
What she was suffering for years.
Yes.
Her mother was healed, and God gave her breakthrough. That
marital.
Is
yes, marital breakthrough.
Marriage.
The miracle of apple and this miracle babies of Christ Messiah Deliverance Ministry is
cannot be overemphasized.
Cannot. You know, even if you don't believe, like one of our brothers who testified in the 2014 I Must Carry My Samuel.
Yes, wow, that brother never believed in miracles.
Yes.
But
as he will say.
But you know, in a way God forced him to believe. You know, he said something when he came to testify. He said, "Is not just him, his family also do not believe in miracles." So when he came across Mercy TV, he was a kind of
hiding. What a lot of people do.
But actually, talking about those people, they don't believe. I don't blame them. Because when the Spirit of God appeared to Abraham and told us Sarah would conceive,
Sarah doubted. You know one thing I think
it's been happening like from the very beginning of creation to this moment.
You know, it's good for your doubts to draw you close to God, to know
and give you what you need.
Yes.
Okay, so for our viewers to get
what we're saying,
let us go back and watch the clip. We'll be just right back.
Mercy Land.
Arena of Solution and Power.
Mercy Land.
Arena of Solution and Power.
My name is Rostom Etafe Ikutegbere. I'm from Delta State here, but the person standing beside me is my wife. We have been married since March 29, 1999.
How many years?
13 years.
13 good years. You married her 13 good years.
Yes.
What happened to the marriage?
Well, I'm a Jehovah's Witness.
Okay.
I don't even believe in miracle. The only miracle we believe is that when you sleep, you wake the next day. That is a miracle from God, and it ends there. So on the month of June.
You married her for 13 years.
Yes, sir.
Plus.
So June 2013. My wife's mother, that's my mother-in-law, they phoned me from Ekiti State. They said that they are coming to Warri, that I should come and pick them in Niger Delta TB Joshua Church.
Oh!
So when I went to my office, I called one of my boys. Which one be Niger Delta TB Joshua? Then the boy was laughing at me. He said, so not be Warri I day. I said, yes. He said, then he mentioned Mercy Land Deliverance Ministry.
Okay.
Then I asked him, where is that church? Then he said, at
Jakpa Road.
Jakpa Road, thank you.
Very good.
Then that, the day that my stepmother came, then she called me that they are now in Jakpa Road, I should come. Then I called my wife, we entered my vehicle, we drove down, we started tracing the place until we got here.
Okay.
Then I called her that I'm in the church now. Where are you? Then they said that they are in the church. Then we came into the church. Initially, I don't want to sit. I don't want to come and sit.
Yes.
Then
because,
she said,
because you don't believe miracle. Yes. Go ahead.
Yes. Then we came.
He's saying
in
the truth. Go ahead.
We sat down with my wife. We sat close to my mother-in-law. Then they were praying. I was not even willing to pray.
You are not comfortable.
No. So
the prayers are not correspond with you.
No.
Go ahead.
Then that very day, there was a testimony that was going on. The testimony actually.
Listen to that one again. Take
pricked,
that one.
The testimony pricks me. When I got home, the next day I went to my office. I told my boy that, this was self now, another strong TB Joshua.
Okay.
Then he said, yes, that's so, sir. He said they are even on television. He said television, said yes, they have Mercy TV. Then something just pricked me. I went over because opposite me there is one DSTV distributor. I asked him if he has a decoder. Then he said yes. Then I said, okay, give me one. He gave me one. He sent his boy along with me to my house, installed it. The first channel that he tuned was the Mercy TV.
Hey, Willie! Pakurana!
Then I called my wife. I said, see the Mercy TV. Then we started watching. That day, we watched for some hours. Then I went out. Then we are having this problem of infertility for the 13 years.
Do you go to hospital? Child. Do you go to hospital?
Yes, I have my doctor report. Several
okay,
hospitals.
Okay, let me see the doctor reports.
I cannot count. There are up to 21 hospitals, both Warri,
Port Harcourt. Port Harcourt, more than 21 hospitals.
Benin.
Yes.
So, the last one, the doctor told me.
I'm not hearing you.
The doctor told me, or guy called me and my wife. He said, your sperm is
low sperm.
Low sperm. That you cannot impregnate your wife.
Ewele.
So, what will we do for you? Go to Port Harcourt and adopt a child. When I got home that very day, after I installed the decoder, the next day, as I tuned the television, the man of God was praying. He said, one word he said was that, whether you believe or you don't believe.
Oh, Jehovah Witness. Jehovah Witness.
My God is going to work for you.
He will work for you.
Yes.
Very
then,
good.
We don't have apple. We don't even have water. We don't have anything.
Okay.
We don't even believe.
Okay.
But my wife said that we should pray with the man of God now. And I said, no apple. She said she have a banana in the fridge.
Power! That's God for you. Bah! Oh, ho.
Then my wife rushed into the kitchen, get the banana.
Banana!
Then we prayed along with the man of God.
Banana!
We were saying amen. So after the prayer, we both shared the banana. My wife ate and I ate.
Banana!
Yes. So after eating the banana,
You ate with her?
Both of us ate it together.
She ate half,
I ate half.
Okay.
Then that evening, we met our husband and wife.
Okay.
Just 2 weeks.
2 weeks?
2 weeks.
2 weeks?
I was expecting my wife to say menstrual pain. But what I found was that she ran into the kitchen and to the toilet and she started vomiting.
Hey! Power! Power!
Power!
I asked her what is wrong. She said that she don't know.
Huh?
Then she said she don't know that
she don't know
that the stomach is
now play I go blow.
There is something moving in her stomach. I said okay. The next day the same thing. The third day the same thing.
Oh, yeah.
Then after a week, she's supposed to see her menses. No menstruation. Then I said okay, go to the doctor and see what is going on. She went. She went for this pregnancy test. The doctor said that your wife is pregnant. Now, why are you bringing her here?
Which doctor? Which doctor? The same. It's the same doctor that one of them that just tested her.
Yes, the same doctor who said that.
One of them that tested her.
Yes.
Who gave a doctor report?
Yes.
That you are having a low sperm count.
Yes.
The thing they worry for.
So the doctor said that my wife is pregnant.
Hey!
Then he was asking, what happened now, guy?
Okay, the man asked you.
Yes.
The doctor asked you.
Yes.
He said what?
He said, what happened? How come? What drug did you take? Because he was the one treating me. I spent over ₦1 million looking for this baby.
Hey! So
he said, what happened? What drug did you take? Because he has given me all the drugs. The one I would drink, the injection, he has given me all the drug. So she just said I should go and adopt, but he was surprised. Then I said, I went to a church. He said, which church? I said, Mercy TV. He said, Mercy Land. He said, is that so? He said,
okay.
Then he was surprised. He said, okay, go. Then he said, I should come back again.
Okay.
After 3 months, my wife went back. They did the same test. The test showed she's 3 months down. The doctor said, now, Belen. So
grow.
I went home again.
Grow.
Now my wife grow. Is 6 months down now.
So how do you feel again?
So, I was reluctant to come and give the testimony.
Reluctantly.
But because of the miracle was too much for me, I couldn't believe it. Because some of my Christian brothers, they died barren. Because no way to pray. So many of them died barren.
Uh-huh.
And I'm not a small boy. I'm over 40 years.
Okay.
And my time is running out.
Okay.
So this is a great thing that God has done.
Okay.
So I told my ministry that
woman,
I will not
God.
Be coming again.
What the Lord told me,
categorically,
he said, if any man or woman
si un homme ou femme,
that will refuse to believe the God that called you,
que
I will force them
je vais les forcer
to believe you.
À croire.
Welcome back, viewers. You just listened to that wonderful testimony. Wow. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13
Not just 13 years. The man was... Okay. Not just 13 years. He was once married and all through the first marriage, there was no issue.
So,
and
so
even this... He had to stay this long. And
he waited in the first marriage. I'm not sure there was a child there.
There was a child.
And then.
And that was why the marriage was divorced.
He had to wait again in another marriage for 13 years.
13 years. That's why he never believed when he went home.
Yeah.
God is so wonderful. He is a Christian, but doesn't believe in miracles.
He does not believe in miracles.
As I would say, I don't believe in miracles, but how this came about.
You blame him because
and do you know what's significant thing? He said it wasn't even with an apple.
Yes, that's
it was with a banana fruit.
Yeah, and they were just eating and dying. But the man of God was praying with the apple, they said, okay, is there any fruits in the
banana.
House? It's just got the banana from. Fruits is fruits.
Yes.
And that's what Madam would always say. Any fruits can connect to any fruit. But the just apple, believe. The apple was spelled out in the Bible.
Yeah.
That the apple fruits will bring out.
Yes. Mm-hmm. And one thing that I saw in that program, 2014, I Must Carry My Sermon program, is the ladies that delivered fibroid live, we saw it. You know, as they will testify, this has been an hindrance to them. Even at 2015 crusade, this keeps happening. Yeah, this keeps happening.
The program I Must Carry My Sermon.
And you know, some of these fibroid cases, this fibroid of a thing, some people go into an operation and they die.
Okay, go. And even
and some go for operations of operation upon operation and still.
It's just what
like that. The lady of the year 2015, when she just read the Bible portion and the fibroid came out, as she came out to testify, she said she has gone through an operation for twice. She has gone through the operation
and still she was still diagnosed.
Going for another one.
What was so wonderful was that immediately the fibroid came out. We all saw it, and even the year 2014, I Must Carry My Sermon program. The fibroid came out, the lady just went to the toilet, she was pressed.
Yeah, even the demonstration when the men of God went, during several programs, when the men of God demonstrate, you know, several times when we're on program, the men of God calls out those looking for the fruit of the womb to come with their apples. And when the men of God demonstrate, prays for them, we see that so many who have been diagnosed of this fibroid delivers fibroid. Wow, so we're going.
I'm thinking, this fiber, it keeps multiplying even sometimes after operation. No, I'm not a woman, I'm not a medical doctor.
With
what I have seen, it keeps multiplying after operation. But when these people come to church, they deliver and that's it. They just pass on the fiber.
You know, there's a name. It's God is the greatest physician.
Yes.
Doctors call him the greatest physician.
You know something.
He permeates it.
The case of the lady of 2014 crusade. 2014, I Must Carry My Sermon. It was a multiple fibroid. Let's watch a clip and see how the fibroid came out.
Mercy Land.
Arena of Solution and Power.